Welcome to EPG Pathshala. My name is Dr. Amit Katoch and I am working as Assistant Professor in University Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management of Punjab University. I am presenting lecture on module titled Airport Cargo Rates and Charges, General Rules, Minimum Rates, Normal Rates, etc. under the paper titled Cargo Operations and Management. After completing this module, the learners would be able to understand firstly, I will discuss about the brief introduction. Air cargo is a significant and key economic sector of any nation which supports poverty reduction, employment generation, and making nations more productive. It plays a significant role in the development of global economy by delivering high quality products at competitive prices to consumer. Globally, air cargo accounts for less than 1% of trade shipments by volume and around 35% by value. An airline generates on an average 9% of business from cargo, which represents higher than twice the revenue generated from the first class segment. Digitalization is now the norm for the air cargo industry to operate efficiently and provide quality and reliable services to customers. Now I will discuss about basic terminology used in air cargo rates and charges. Air cargo tariff means tariff containing charges and rates applicable to the scheduled air cargo transportation in foreign nationals. It contains the charges like air freight rate and surcharges on fuel, insurance, security, airway bill, dangerous goods, and express rate. The rates cover transportation from the airport of loading to the airport of discharge. IATA member airlines adhere with the air cargo tariff issued by IATA in the manual TACT. To understand the air cargo rates and charges, one must know the basic terms, which are as follows. Rate classification. A rate is a price in which goods are transported from one destination to another. The rate of the cargo goods depends upon the type of goods, the weight of the goods, and the distance to the delivery destination. Airlines classify the rates into two basic types. General cargo rates, that is GCR. These rates are for the general goods for shipment. These rates are further divided on the basis of time taken to transport the goods, like normal, express, and time definite. Under normal rate class, the airlines transit the goods up to 20 days. In express rate, the airlines transport the goods within 48 hours, but the charges are higher than the normal rate. In the time definite class of GCR, the charges are higher than the express rate class and the goods are transported within the time frame as specified by the customer. Special commodity rates, SCR. These rates are offered by the airlines for specific commodities, but charges are lower than the general cargo rates. Those goods are transported which have specific descriptions like perishable and dangerous goods. Other types of rates are net rate. This rate is offered by the airlines without commission. Spot rates or ad hoc rates. The airlines offered spot rate on a specific flight and on a specific shipment. In this case, the customer has to ready cargo itself for the transportation. All-in rate. Rates plus surcharges are called all-in rate, which airlines offers for specific flights and for limited period only. Unit load device rate. This rate is used for the storage of the cargo goods on the aircraft, and the storage devices are further divided into two types, pallets and containers. The design of pallets are L1, L2, L3, L4 and L9 for containers variant. Contract rate. It is a discount rate set up by contractual agreement between an air carrier and a shipper to a minimum volume for a defined period of time. Basis of rates and charges. It is based on the units of measurement and subject to the rules and conditions published in carriers' regulations and rate tariffs. The payment is made in the currency shown in the applicable rate tariffs issued by the airline. Airway bill. It is a document used by the airlines for the transportation of goods, which specifies the contract for carriage and carrier conditions of carriage, such as limits of liability and claims procedures. A standard format is used by the airlines for air freight at domestic and international level. The description of the goods applicable, carriage charges and the shipping instructions to the airline are also mentioned on the airway bill. It is also known as the bill of lading. Chargeable weight. It can be volume or dimensional or gross weight. It is calculated to determine air freight charges. Gross weight is the full weight of a shipment, that is both the weight of containers and goods. On the airway bill, both weights are listed separately. Dimensional weight is calculated by dividing the shipment volume by the minimum density requirement. The minimum density requirement varies from air cargo carrier to carrier. High density goods claim discounts from the air cargo carriers. Consignment. It is a shipment of one or more than one pieces of goods accepted by the air cargo company from one consigner at a time, received for the specified lot and forwarded on one airway bill. Consignee. It is a person or a company on behalf of them. Air carrier transports and delivers goods to the concerned party or destination. Its name is also written on the airway bill. Consignor. It is a person or a company making an agreement with the air carrier for the transportation of the goods. Its name is also written on the airway bill. Consolidation. It is the assembly of more than one shipment and carried on a single airway bill from one destination to another. Consolidator. It is also known as air freight forwarder. It is a firm or a company which collects all the small shipments and assembles them into one shipment and forwards to the final destination through air cargo carrier. Minimum weight. The lowest weight of shipment on which the freight rate is applied. Minimum charge. The lowest rate applied on the air cargo service irrespective of the minimum size and weight of the shipment. Rate slabs. On the basis of weight, freight rates on the following slabs are N, normal weight or below 45 kg, and various slabs such as plus 45, plus 100, plus 250, plus 300, plus 500, etc. M, minimum rate up to certain weight or per shipment. Now I will discuss about IATA and Air Cargo. International Air Transport Association, that is IATA, is an association of airlines with a mission to represent, lead and serve the industry. Globally, around 265 commercial airlines serve more than 83% of the total air traffic. Are the members of this association, IATA supports the air cargo business and committed to improve the quality of sustainable air cargo supply chain. Most of the nations follow an open sky policy for the carriage of freight, and IATA helps the various nations and airlines to arrive at bilateral and multilateral agreements to frame the flying rights. The most important task that IATA achieved is to make the customer experience hassle-free by introducing interline cooperation in carrying cargoes on available with payment in single currency. IATA Cargo Committee set an agenda in which it identified the 4 areas of focus and 10 industry key priorities. Now I will discuss about IATA and TACT. The air cargo tariff, that is TACT, is an important guide for the companies working in the global air cargo value chain. It is used by more than 70,000 air cargo professionals on a daily basis. It is published by IATA thrice a year for airlines, forwarders, brokers, agents, airport and custom authorities. The information contained in the manual is divided into 3 books: Rules, North American Rates, and the Worldwide Rates. It is a reference guide which provides quick access to the rules related to air cargo industry as well as global rates and information. The usage of this manual leads to the accurate and timely decisions taken by its users, provides competitive pricing for airlines and freight forwarders, enhances efficiency and visibility for airlines to freight forwarders globally, and provides up-to-date industry regulations to agents, brokers, airlines, forwarders, airport and custom authorities. This manual provides 4.5 million rates for 350,000 city pairs. The manual provides the detailed information of IATA rules and regulations on the acceptance of goods and completion of airway bill. The rules, regulations and charges of member countries on import, transit and export, the information regarding storage and handling equipment facilities at the airports, and also airline, airport and city codes information. Now I will discuss about air cargo services in India. Earlier in India, cargo transfer was done dominantly with the sea route, and air cargo has a negligible share of the total cargo transported from and to India. The goods transported by air are perishables, electronics, pharmaceuticals, textiles, valuable cargo and express mail items with time-bound delivery. Air cargo reduces transit time as compared to shipping by sea because goods transits by air are higher in value and low in volume. To boost the air cargo in India, Air Cargo Open Sky Policy was adopted in 1992, in which any domestic or international carrier could follow the guidelines specified for operational and safety requirements for air cargo services to and from India to provide scheduled and non-scheduled air cargo services from any ports of India where customs facilities were available. IATA forecast the 4.1% CAGR, that is compound annual growth rate, over the next 5 years at the international freight market of India. IATA's Director General and CEO Tony Tytler said that growth in freight tons has averaged just 0.63% per year. Air cargo industry of India is expanding with the support and key initiatives taken by the government, like foreign direct investment, entry of low-cost carriers, increased cargo movement with the establishment of manufacturing facilities, etc. The international and domestic freight traffic has shown growth of 10.8% to 7% respectively, resulting into overall increase of 9.3% in total freight traffic during the period. For the growth of air cargo industry of India, the major steps taken by the Government of India are: at 13 airports, 24/7 customs clearance service of import and export cargo has been started. From April 1, 2017, free period for air cargo has been reduced from 72 hours to 48 hours. Single window concept by customs and online clearance from various regulatory agencies has been initiated from April 1, 2016. At Chennai and Kolkata airports, Airports Authority of India has provided elevated transfer vehicle ETV and automatic storage and retrieval system, that is AS&RS, for handling international cargo. Airports Authority of India equipped all the international air cargo terminals with cargo handling equipments, cold rooms for perishable cargo, and other basic facilities. AAI also introduced Common User Domestic Cargo Terminal, that is CUDCT, for maximum utilization of services by the domestic air cargo service providers. To ensure equal growth of all regions, Airports Authority of India prepares a plan to create air cargo infrastructure and facilities at 24 AAI airports. Now I will discuss about Department of Cargo in Airports Authority of India, Ministry of Civil Aviation India. Department of Cargo is headed by the Executive Director with the aim of performing various corporate functions and formulating corporate policies on cargo handling at the airports of India. It is the governing body which implements International Air Transport Association rules, International Civil Aviation Organization's recommendations, implementation of Bureau of Civil Aviation Security rules, and Central Board of Excise and Customs objectives and regulations related to cargo handling. It builds and maintains relation with the regulatory bodies and other user agencies like CBEC, Director General of Civil Aviation, and Ministry of Commerce. This department also represents Airport Authority of India in the various trade bodies like Federation of Freight Forwarders Association of India, that is FFFAI, Air Cargo Agents Association of India, that is ACAAI, Federation of Indian Exporters Organization, that is FIEO, Chambers of Commerce, that is CII, conventions and high-level meetings arranged by the Bar India Cargo. It performs an important role by setting up cargo terminals, modernization and hassle-free cargo handling system, and providing services comparable to international standards. Cargo tariff is finalized for cargo handling is done by the Department of Cargo in consideration with the airlines and freight forwarders. It also makes proposals and frame policies for the smooth running of cargo operations and presents it to Airport Authority of India Board for its approval. Department of Cargo take initiatives for the training programs of cargo personnel in consultation with Executive Director Training to develop professionalism amongst the employees of Airport Authority of India. There are many facilities established by the Airports Authority of India at cargo terminals at various international airports, which are as follows. All regulatory and facilitating agencies at one place. Separate storage, processing and examination areas for import, export and TP cargo. Separate unaccompanied baggage unit, ETV system with built-in ULD weighing facility, X-ray screening, cargo apron for freighter, CCTV monitoring, live animal sheds, hazardous cargo shed and radioactive material sheds, automated storage and retrieval system, state-of-art center for perishable cargo, strong room for valuable cargo, basic services like canteen, bank, post office, vehicle parking, photocopier, weigh scale, etc. Now I will discuss about AAI Airports Cargo Charges and Tariff. The charges charged are TSP, that is Transfer, Storage and Processing, and demurrage charges at cargo terminal of Airports Authority of India airports, except Chennai and Kolkata airports, where AERA approved charges are applicable. Export cargo. Here, TSP charges, that is transfer, storage and processing charges for general, special and perishable cargo are charged. It is also charged per kilogram. Demurrage charges levyable from shipper refers to the charges that the ship owner pays to the charterer for its delayed operations of loading and unloading. Also, the free period for examination and processing by the shippers for export cargo shall be 24 hours. 10% discount on TSP charges will be given to consigners who use their own loaders for offloading cargo from their vehicles at truck dock and shifting to custom examination area. Newspaper and TV reel consignments shall get 50% of the given TSP charges. The TSP and demurrage charges are not applicable on consignments of human remains, coffin, including unaccompanied baggage of deceased and human eyes. Forklift charges are included in the terminal storage and processing charges. Charges will be applicable on the gross weight or the chargeable weight of the consignment, whichever is higher. If the gross weight or volume weight is wrongly indicated on the AAway bill and is found, more charges will be applicable on the actual gross weight or actual volumetric weight, whichever is higher. On the misdeclaration of weight above 2% of declared weight, penal charges at the rate of double the applicable TSP charges, and for the variation of weight above 5% of declared weight, the penal charges at the rate 5 times the applicable TSP charges would be applicable. No penal charges will be leviable for variation up to and inclusive of 2%. It is not applicable to valuable cargo. All the bills shall be rounded off to the nearest of rupees 5 as per IATA tax rulebook clause 5.7.2. The rounding off procedure for the rounding off unit is 5. When the results of calculation are between 102.5 to 107.5, the amount is rounded to 105, and when it is 107.5 to 112.4, then the amount is rounded to 110. MOT merchant overtime charges at the rate rupees 200 per consignment for admitting cargo beyond normal working hours. If export admitted between 1000 hours to 1500 hours, 20% discount will be levied in the TSP charges, subject to levy of minimum rate per consignment as given in the scale of charges. Now coming to import of cargo. TSP, that is transfer storage and processing charges, for general, special and perishable cargo. It is charged per kilogram. Demurrage charges refers to the charges that the ship owner pays to the charterer for its delayed operations of loading or unloading. Officially, demurrage is a form of liquidated damages for breaching the lay time, as it is stated in the governing contract, that is the charter party. It is charged per kilogram. The various things which should be noted for import cargo are: terminal storage and processing and demurrage charges will be exempted on consignments of human remains, coffin including baggage of deceased and human eyes. Forklift charges are exempted on import cargo. Charges will be applicable on the gross weight or the chargeable weight of the consignment, whichever is higher. Wherever the gross weight or volume weight is wrongly indicated on the AWA bill and is actually found more, charges will be levied on the actual gross weight or actual volume weight or chargeable weight, whichever is higher. Valuable cargo valued at $1000 per kg and above. All the bills shall be rounded off to the nearest of rupees 5 as per IATA tact rule book. Clause 5.7.2, the rounding off procedure for the rounding off unit is 5. So when the results of calculation are between 102.5 to 107.4, the figures are rounded to 105, and for 107.5 to 112.4, the figures are rounded to 110. Dock charges leviable on shippers and consigners. For that, there shall be free one working day for examination, processing by the shipper, consigner, authorized representative, etc., for outbound domestic cargo. Also, shippers or consigners who engaged their own loaders for offloading cargo from their vehicles at truck dock and shifting to the examinations or storage area before handling over to the airlines concerned, 10% discount in the domestic cargo handling charges is given. Newspaper and TV reel assignments shall be 50% of the prescribed domestic cargo handling charges. Also, domestic cargo handling charges and demurrage charges are not applicable on consignment of human remains, coffin, including unaccompanied baggage of deceased and human eyes. Also, no separate forklift charges are applicable. They are inclusive of domestic cargo handling charges. Charges will be applicable on the gross weight or the chargeable weight of the consignment, whichever is higher. If the gross weight or volume weight is wrongly indicated on the AWA bill and is found more, then in that case, charges will be applicable on the actual gross weight or actual volumetric weight, whichever is higher. On the misdeclaration of weight above 2% of declared weight, penal charges at the rate of double the applicable domestic cargo handling charges, and for the variation of weight above 5% of declared weight, the penal charges